Hey guys, so today is Sunday the 19th. Every time I record, I always have to hold my phone and make sure what date it is. It's like I'm scatterbrained, I don't know what date it is. I hear sounds. Don't ask me what week I'm at, that's why I'm referring to my phone, but then it's like my phone says one thing, the app, and Dr. tells me something, and I never pay attention, which I should be. I'm such an irresponsible new mommy to be. So I'm just gonna show you. I don't know. July 19th, week 24. I thought it was like close to 25 weeks. I don't know. I don't know. But it says the baby is the size of a ear corn, ear of corn. But anyways, nothing drastic, but the baby is kicking a little bit stronger. I'm really sweating, it's like muggy. I just did when I'm wearing a video, which you will see after my vlog. Had a lot of fun, but it was hot and it's been raining for like 2 months straight, and the last 2 days it decides to be extra muggy and gloomy. That's Ohio for you. But yeah, ooh, I can't breathe. But yeah, stronger kicks, which is probably still like a flutter. I'm confused. I don't know, but I feel it. It's like this vibration thing in your bed, and it will be on the right side, and sometimes I'll feel it on the left side. And the past few days, I feel so much pressure on my bladder. The baby's probably sitting on my bladder because before I used to be able to like hold my pee and not go because I'm just so anal when I'm at a public air or just a restroom, toilet that's not my own house. I'm very paranoid. Like, I would not go on a different toilet. Even the thought of squatting. So, now at work, I can't. I have to go like every freaking like 30 minutes. Even when I'm not drinking any water, I'm peeing like a freaking horse. So I'm like, where's the water coming from? The baby, I don't know. I don't know. You think I know a lot considering the medical field, but I know nothing about babies or babies in your body. But so far so good. I don't know if you guys are out there like me or weird and crazy, but days that I don't feel her moving or kicking flutters or whatever, I'm like, am I pregnant? Am I really pregnant? Like, until now, like, I'm over 5 months and I'm like, am I really pregnant? So like a couple days ago, my app goes on and it says, I can't remember the exact term it's called. I'll probably put the name on the bottom somewhere. I don't know. But there's this black line that starts from like your belly in the middle, past your umbilical area, all the way to your vajayjay. This very faint, dark black line. And I'm like, that's confirmation that you are preggo because that's the sign it says, and preggo people get that. It's the pigmentation on your skin when you're preggo or something, and it will disappear when you give birth. I don't know, but when I saw it, I'm like, oh shit, I am preggo. Like, I've been pregnant, but it's like weird. So that's what I've been feeling. No nausea, no vomiting. I've never vomited since day one. Just nausea, thank God. But I have been feeling a little bit tired. But not as bad as it was the first 2 months, but it's tired a lot. And I eventually quit my part-time job at Burlington because I just had enough of being there for almost 3 years, and a girl can only take so much. A pregnant girl can only take so much from unnecessary attitude, and it's just a part-time job. Burlington's like whatever to me, and I loved working there. The staff loved me, but there's been days when I'm like, I sacrifice my time, and can't talk. Basically, I sacrifice my time coming all the way there, pretty much living in Columbus, driving on the east side of Columbus to my regular job, going around to another part of Columbus, which is like another 30 minutes away. I'm basically driving around the whole city of Columbus from west side where I am, east side where I work, and north? North? Yeah, I don't know. So it's like they don't effing see it, and certain people want to be supervisors there, do not know how to control their anger professionally, so they lash out on who's ever there, aka me, aka the only one that's been there forever and knows everything, aka those couple days been working with newbies. It's so annoying. So I'm like, this is the last day, and basically they've been losing a lot of great people the last 2 years, so, and I'm one of them, so, but they don't care because they'll hire new people anyway, but they'll be stressed for a while because it takes time to hire just anybody in training, blah, blah, blah. But it feels so good to just not work the weekend. And this weekend I had an amazing weekend. Partially annoyed because I have a lot of pet peeves with people. But went to a festival, which I've never been to, and I did this year because Prego equals cravings. And just, oh, there's one more fair coming up soon. I'm looking so forward to that. But this one was the Jazz and Rib Festival. Ribs, which I've... Oh, I've just been craving for lots of meat lately. Like, I'm a meat person, but not a really, really, I want meat all the time. But the past week, 2 weeks, I'll say, I just want to bite on some good-ass meat. And I'm not picky. Yeah, so it's... Oh, God, the ribs were so good. And leftover ribs was the bomb. Like, when people say on a cooking channel or whatever, when the meat falls off the bone, oh, it's so good. And it's not just drizzled hella barbecue sauce. It was just perfect. That's how I like it, because I want to taste the meat, not the barbecue sauce. And then I ended up going a second time yesterday evening with my other friend. She's going through some stuff. My first friend, she was a little bit special. I have a lot of pet peeves. I might have to do another video about that. Or maybe I'm just like a bitch. But evening, it was fun. It's nicer when you have people that you relate with, that you click with. And she mentioned how no matter how long we don't talk, when we see each other, it feels the same. It's not awkward. And those are one of the few people that you will have in your life. And you just know it. There's one person that you're like, okay, awkward. Another person, what's up, bitch? A year later, still my bitch. Just saying. I'm saying bitch because earlier. I'm so random. I live in, like, not so great part of town. My neighbor, if we can, like, fight like every damn week, and two grown ass men woke up when I was trying to nap. I probably like fell asleep like an hour already, and I kind of like, whoa, what? So anyway, all I heard was like, bitch this, bitch that, and this and that. It's two white boys, grown white boys. I'm like, I don't know what they were fighting about. They were talking to slang, I guess, and I'm like, no, and the only words I picked up was bitch, bitch, bitch this, bitch that. This is a weekly thing for me, my poor child. And I opened up a second checking account with my bank. I have a savings also, and it's for Ava. It's mine, but the money has been saved up for Ava since I found out I was pregnant. It's going well, because there's a lot of things I need to buy. There's things that I have to buy traditionally, and because I want to, because I grew up having it, and it's just in my culture, which I'll explain later. Some people might be like, that's not important, saving money for the most important things, you know, stuff like that. But I made a checking account with the same bank that I already have, but it won't be under a baby's name. I want that money to use, and I will, oh God, I can't talk, I'm so out of breath. I'll just keep putting random amount of money in there, 20, 40, 50, all the way into like 18 or whatever. And that money will be used when I need to buy major things for my daughter, a car, college fund, stuff like that. My parents didn't do that for me, but growing up I had a piggy bank, and I had so much Christmas money, birthday money, allowance and stuff. And as a kid, I never bought anything. My parents got me everything growing up, all the way until I was like 18, 19, 20, or whatever, I think. Yeah, I've had an okay childhood considering some stuff that happened to me in life. But, yeah, the fact that I didn't buy anything as a kid, my piggy bank had like thousands and thousands and thousands of money. Let's just say when I was, before mistakes and stupid shit happened in life, aka my fault and stupidity, I had freaking like $10,000 when I was like in my early 20s. It's all gone. But yeah, so those are little things I want to do for my daughter. And my mom has been pretty nice, which is creepy to me. She's asking about baby. She's not ridiculing me. I'm talking slang words in Cambodian, root words, and it means a lot. So no more fighting and bitching and making me cry. Baby daddy's been kind of like MIA, long story. I'll probably mention that in another video because then I'm just going to go babbling about him. But don't worry, he's not abusing me. He's just special. That's the only word I can say. But haven't been around for like 2 weeks. He's been busy too, working. He works like sometimes some days a week too. So work has been okay. Drama with 3 people, not including me, but I'm there seeing and it's ridiculous. I'm having cravings for a lot of sweets and meat, but yeah, yep. We have so much stuff, other random stuff to tell you about. I'll talk in another video. But anyway, I did a video before this one showing what I'm wearing, and I hope you guys like it. It's not necessarily maternity outfits, but it works because I don't personally plan on, I have 4 months left, so I haven't bought any like actual maternity clothes except for my shorts, which I bought at the beginning when I first found out I was preggo. And besides that, all my other clothes were wear clothes, just a little bit bigger, and it's comfortable because, I mean, if your lifestyle consists of going out a lot with your homies and that's how your life is, yeah, go ahead and buy your cute maternity clothes. It means like I work, I go out like once a week, so I don't need that much stuff, and it'll be like a waste of money. And most of my clothes fit me nicely and it's loose, and yeah. And I plan, the clothes I bought recently, I plan to wear them when I'm not preggo anymore, so it works well. That's why not necessarily maternity clothes, or actually normal clothes that just fits me as a preggo woman. So yeah, I hope you like my clothes. Yeah, I haven't done one of those videos in a long time. I get excited and very enthusiastic and feel creative, even though I just don't know anything about making nice quality videos, but this is me, this is real, it's live or whatever. I wasn't almost gonna do it, but I was like, okay, get up, Brenda. House is clean, room is clean, laundry's done, do something instead of laying in bed and your belly watching YouTube, which I love YouTube. So, and of course, thank you for all the new subscribers, and yeah, it's nice. It's still so surreal that I have a baby in my belly. Her name is Ava. I'm trying to decide on a middle name, which I will eventually let you guys know and maybe have you guys help me decide. Haven't bought the pack and play nor the stroller yet. I think I'll buy it like maybe a month before. I'm just not ready to like have that here yet because it's probably going to hit me or something. I don't know. And decorating the wall or whatever. I don't know. So guys, that is my update for this week. And I'll see you guys soon. Enjoy the video in a few minutes. Love ya. Bye. Hope all is well. Thank you so much for all the new subscribers. And of course, rate, comment, and subscribe. So I bought this dress a couple weeks ago at Target because I wanted something flowy and caught my eye, and it had a nice bright color and it sure looked like a baby doll dress. Very comfortable, not a maternity outfit, but it works well, and my bump pops up a little bit, it's even cuter. I wore it to a show I went a few weeks ago, which was awesome. And of course, cardigans are my best friend. I don't have the prettiest arm stretch marks, bite marks here and there, so I wear a cardigan. If you have a great body, just floss your skin out, but I love the way it looks, so it's very comfortable, very light, very flowy. Here's another outfit, tank top, and I don't know what kind of pants they're called, but it's very popular. I got it at my job at Burlington, and they only had one size, which was extra large, my size, and the rest were small, medium, and they were gone, so I wish I could find more. They're so freaking comfortable, and it's nice, of course, very light material, feels good in your skin, makes it nice and cool, especially in the summertime. Look at me, I'm about to fall down. Lord, but yeah, they're so comfy. I used to wear them back in the day. I think all the old school stuff is coming back. Don't fall. I'm trying to be careful. I'm clumsy. Here's another one. I call these hammer pants, also got burnt. And it's been in to get so many designs, florals, patterns, whatever. So comfortable. And it's not too hot over here. It's just very light feeling. And of course, bandits are your best friend when you pray go. And it comes with a string, but I didn't bother. Just kind of tuck it in. It's perfect the way it is. Yep. That's all. Look at me. What am I doing? Okay. Keep going. I'm listening to some like old school Hillary Duff, and she was singing an old school song, so I was like dancing to it. And this dress really shows my bump. I bought it a few months ago as well. Yes, I'm having extra back fat now. Don't hate. I'm proud of it. And it really accentuates my bump. I have a black one too, and I wore that one too, a Burlington, because we can't wear black. But I have to get a different color too, and I just love it. It's very comfortable. It is, however, getting a little tight, but it's still wearable, and it just looks cute with a cardigan, of course. And this is my favorite. I haven't worn this out yet, but I'm hoping if I have a party or something, or a special occasion before I give birth, this is gonna be my favorite baby dress. Look, more extra back fat. Okay, no need to tell me. Ooh. So, that's my first maxi dress. I also have a hard time because it's really long, as you can see, but this one's too cute. I couldn't resist. I'm gonna have my mom hem it for me, but I really think I look really cute in this for a bigger girl. I'm dancing again, playing some old school Hillary Duff. Oh, yeah. And it's very comfortable, very light. And I think that looks good for all shapes and sizes. Last one, I bought a bunch of maternity shorts. Those are the only outfits that are actually for maternity. That top, however, is not maternity. I bought it a few months before I even found out I was pregnant, and it looks like it should be a maternity top. I have that in a dark blue as well, and it's so comfortable. I've been wearing that, so I didn't bother buying any other outfits. So have mine. The only maternity thing I bought were shorts, and I have a bunch more different patterns. I got one with the spandex covering my belly, and this one is nice too, it's comfy. With laces and stuff. I got a dark blue, a lighter blue, a white one. So that is it. Hope you guys enjoy my video. Rate, comment, subscribe, and let me know what you guys are wearing. Bye!